Good afternoon, everyone. Mount Carmel Hospital in Columbus, Ohio, 1886. There's no people. But less than 20 years later, you need to ask yourself, is this even the same original building? Another strange hospital in Columbus, out of nowhere, Mount Francis. And staying on the theme of hospitals, 1907, Knoxville, Tennessee. Notice the shadows in the driveway off the shrubs. Again, no people, although the largest hospital in the city. 1920s image, you see the same exact shadows. It looks like they photoshopped the cars in there. On to incredible architecture here. Union Station, Columbus, Ohio, 1908. Built in 1860. Greek architecture on the arches. Looks very much like the Woman's Building in Knoxville, Tennessee. And an underutilized motorcycle design from the 1920s. And did you notice every one of those images had those Tartarian antenna on top? Here we go, deep dive into the Mudflood hospitals. As Americans seek economic protection, after the most controversial election in U.S. history, J.P. Morgan Chase is placing billions of dollars for silver to grow more than 100% in 2021. Year to date in 2020 alone, gold is up 30% and silver rising more than 50%. And now we're entering a new year facing economic realities of a global economic crisis caused by COVID and political reactions. Patriot Gold Group has the No Fee for Life IRA, where your IRA or 401k can be in physical gold or physical silver. And you may be eligible for the No Fee for Life IRA. Give them a call at 1-800-356-4470. And the knowledge that Patriot Gold Group is Consumer Affairs' top-rated gold IRA dealer 5 years in a row from 2016 to present. And you work directly with an owner, avoiding absurd fees. To find more information, the link's in the description box below. And now on with the video. And I've seen this a lot researching the more 1860 Civil War era up to the transition in the early 1900s of what was and what is, of what was built and then suddenly switched in just a few decades into something else. And here's another great example. This is the Mount Carmel Hospital. It was opened in 1886. There's not a single construction photo, although the philanthropist of the time, millionaire, is referenced in the one donating the money to get this up and running. Now, the first thing I noticed about the hospital, why would you climb stairs onto the second floor to bring people in for admission? That would be point number one. And if it's the premier hospital of the city at the time, why are there no people around? You don't see any patients, any doctors, nothing. There's one horse carriage to make it appear that it's the 1860s, 1880s, you know, that era of horse and drawn buggy. But the features remain on the next images that you're going to see. But notice how it changes. The facade's ripped off, and then suddenly, in less than 20 years, it turns into this. And you're not even seeing the entire structure. You have to look further down and keep going down and down, which goes over the edge there. So that little tiny hospital was revamped, rebuilt, repurposed from the same structure, apparently, in not even 14 years. And I'm thinking, you know, if there was that much construction going on for that period of a time, how could this even have been a hospital? And what do you notice there? Obviously the cross on the dome, but then you see the antennas that keep appearing again and again in this type of era architecture that is no longer there. If it was truly lightning rods, whatever, it would probably still be there, because if it's a lightning rod, it would be essential for protection. Bringing you up to 1911 here on the same building. Church was built onto the side, multi-story hotel and partial housing for medical staff. All that expansion in just 2.5, 3 years. Wow, that's super amazing. And you notice how it was totally flat in those previous images, and now the hill is contoured off so easily. Explainable, why do they have the small windows at the bottom? And this contour of light, not so easy to see, but you notice the chimneys, and they're similar off the first facade that we saw in the 1886, 1889 era. But it's somehow they split the building in half, widened it out, put doors and windows in the middle, and it just doesn't make sense with what was seen from that first building. It's as if they demolished the entire thing, started from scratch, but left the same chimneys in the windows and the roof facade up there. Pretty interesting on that switch, but changing the contour, you can definitely see the inset in the windows, and notice the antennas disappeared. Now, there are some postcards of the era that have come out, and then you just get the cheap horse and buggy, seem as they're drawn in. And if you noticed every single image I've showed you, although it was the largest hospital in the city, I've never seen even one person in front of this. It doesn't matter if it's in the 1880s, 1911, 1920, 1908, there's no people at all in any of these photos. It's strange and unusual, to say the least. And you get that same hand-drawn what looks like car in the center there from the 1920s street view of Mount Carmel Hospital. And another street view where there's no people. This is supposed to be the second largest hospital in Columbus at the time. This one has no construction photos, just out of nowhere. But this one even looks a little bit more different in the design principle. It looks like what you would see in old forts or guard towers off of a castle. And if you're going to do any more research on this Gothic piece that looks like it's from the 1500s, Mount Francis Hospital. So you realize in 1849, we were out in California in the United States looking for gold. Civil War, 1865, country completely put into a Great Depression, both north and south, trying to rebuild from massive damage. And somehow these Gothic castles pop out of nowhere. Columbus, Ohio. I'm not putting down Columbus, but really, are you trying to tell me that that was built in 1880-something? Okay. But here in Knoxville, Tennessee, 1907 image here for you. And what I found so interesting on the postcards versus the real quote-unquote photo, I cannot believe the similarities, so much so that it's startling. I'll even present it to you here. The General Hospital, what do you notice again? Nobody in the images. No cars, no patients, no doctors, no ambulances, nothing. But notice the shadows, and you'll see two cars appear, but I still see no other people out front. These are nice single-piece pillars there. Imagine the craftsmanship to put a single-piece column up there would be. That's almost Greek-like. And I know the hue and saturation is a little bit different, so let's put these together, easy for you to see. I realize the top is from 1907, bottom is 1920. The red boxes should say it all for you, and if I leave it up here long enough, you'll start to see different areas with shade, like especially in that first building directly above the first box over there by the hedges, you'll see right under the awning, the shadows are matching up. This is the exact same photo, exactly the same. It's like they photoshopped the cars in there and then released this at a later date and said it's from the 1920s. That's the only possible thing. Those shadows are so perfectly aligned. If you overlap these two photos, you'll see no difference. Use the opacity feature and go see what I mean. Now, another thing in Columbus, Ohio, which really was fascinating for me here, the Union Station, demolished in 1976, built in 1860, apparently. And the earliest photo you can ever find of this thing is 1886. What is it with these dates? That whole thing I did about the University of Tennessee, all those same dates kept coming up, 1886, 1888, and then again, 1907. It seems like it's just a rinse and repeat of all the historical buildings across the U.S. dated in the 1880s, and then there's an upgrade, and the new dates of the new buildings pops up in like 1907 or so, 1903, and it's rinse and repeat. So this type of architecture, notice those antenna. Those are antenna. Those are not lightning rods. Are you kidding me? The filigree at the top and the workmanship on that. If I didn't tell you this was in Columbus, Ohio, where would you have thought this was? Of course you would have said somewhere in Europe. The streetcars would have given it away too. Wait, oh, we have automobiles in America, but all those streetcars that used to be here, they ripped them all up. We've been forced on to. But notice the Greek columns again right there. And I do want to pull in on the antenna that I referenced and notice the staggered roof going up. It looks very much like what you might see in Nepal around some of the stupas. But how is this street scene here? You start to see more automobiles along with the streetcar, but it brings me very much to the same similarities of the Women's Building Chamber of Commerce now in Knoxville, Tennessee, circa. If you were going to guess the date of this building officially, what do you think? 1905, bingo, it fits the same model, does it not? And you can go from city to city and get the same dates with the same type of architecture, with the same out-of-place everything. And why is it there's so many antennas on top of there? You're telling me those are all lightning rods? Okay. Now wait, what do I see in the background there? Is that another Greek cathedral in the very back behind there? I guess it is. Now back to this Union Station from the other direction this time. I was thinking, now, those arches are quite amazing. Look at the workmanship that was done there. And I was trying to zoom in on these photos, but they're really grainy because they were taken quite a long time ago. But lo and behold, I found a high-res photo. This is the underneath of those arches going into that rail station built in 1860. Now, who's doing this kind of work in 1860 in America, pre-Civil War, when they still got mud roads running everywhere in this country? And what's most interesting about that, how did I get this high-res photo? Well, the planners in Columbus thought that this was such a special, such amazing piece of architecture and art that when they demolished the train station, they saved the entrances, plural, both of them, and moved them into the Fine Art Open Air Park. Who's kidding who here? And also another little gem from Columbus, Ohio here, the Armory. Does that not look like part of the out of place, what looked like castle defense positions in the Mount Francis Hospital that I showed you earlier? I mean, how many out of place objects and architecture can there be in this city alone? Oh, so many more. This is just a taste of what's to come. And to leave you on to something interesting here, motorcycle designs that never really made it from the 1920s, but I thought these were spectacular, so I thought I'd bring it to you since I found it in the same vein of images looking for the 1920s. Because once I find an image from the 1880s, I try to match it up and then find the different date ranges. So 1880s, 1890s, 1910, 1900s, 1920s. And I'll see, you know, where it is along that date range. So I'll do like five or six different image searches with the date of time behind it. And you'll see what I keep bringing up. There's a concerted switch going on in our history here. Because you can't really tell me that this little tiny building with no people as the main hospital in the city turned into this major, gigantic main city in the hospital with no people in, what, 14 years or less? It seems like it's a different building altogether. Please leave your comments in the description box below. I'd love to share some history. I'd like to hear your thoughts as well. Also, join me over on Homestead 2030. I'll talk about global liquefaction event is the true name for this scientific event that had occurred that reset part of our history, would explain some of these out-of-place buildings and things morphing our world at the moment with the grand solar minimum intensification, and then how you can get self-sufficient. I know it's a wrapped package, but see what you think. Thanks for watching. Hope you got something out of the video, and I'll see you next time.